Hi, my name's Jake and I work for Region Security Guard. Today we're going to be looking at Niko Omilana's video where he snuck into the KSI versus Logan Paul boxing match ring. Niko Omilana, for those who don't know, is a British YouTuber who's so far managed to sneak into several high-profile boxing matches, and we wanted to break it down, these videos, and have a look at it from a security perspective. This was kind of his biggest hurdle, his biggest obstacle when it comes to these videos, and see if what the security guards did were right, or if there's any improvements that could be made.
With the VIP package, Kenny has a ringside wristband and a ringside pass, so I'm going to make an exact replica of the pass on Photoshop, then go to a print shop and get them printed off for me and George. So I ordered a bunch of golden wristbands and went to a print shop. But it worked, I got my wristband and VIP pass and I was ready for the fight.
So the first thing to note about the video is they actually made fake passes, it looks like, and fake wristbands in order to sort of gain access to the event when obviously they didn't actually have ringside passes. It just looked like they bought normal tickets, so they were able to just get into the event itself. But yeah, fake passes is something, it's pretty common in terms of what guards would have to kind of be on the lookout for. That and like fake money as well. Making sure all passes, all tickets, things like that are legit. They do have some kind of unique identifier on them, if that's a unique code, if that's an NFC on it, something that you can just scan along with a kind of a chip reader or something like that. As long as there is some kind of unique identifying factor with the passes, it should be able to avoid anything like this.
I watched Kenny walk into his VIP seats and he explained to me the only way to get in.
They check this, they don't check wristbands, they check tickets.
So as explained by one of the people here, they do just check the tickets instead of wristbands and stuff like that. This is probably just because wristbands can be replicated pretty easily. Probably just something to keep on you, just, you know, as a general kind of thing. But yeah, unless you have like a valid ticket saying that you are allowed to be ringside, then it's going to be pretty much a no-show.
Now, unfortunately, I bought George an upper tier ticket, which meant I had to sneak him into the floor section. And Kenny had a plan.
Okay, so basically, this is the plan. I'm gonna walk in front, show this. Yeah, you walk behind Naz. Yeah, and Niko is gonna be at the back.
So we followed Kenny's plan, and unfortunately, it didn't work because the woman wouldn't let George through.
So it looks like what they're trying to do here is obviously sandwich kind of someone who doesn't have a ticket in between two people who do. Pretty silly of a tactic, given that obviously everyone's going to get checked for a ticket. It's not like you can kind of just pass through someone if a guard lets you through without checking any kind of credentials or tickets or passes that you have. They're doing a pretty sloppy job, all things considered, and it's shown they obviously get caught immediately.
But Kenny led the way and I followed behind with my fake pass. Was I going to fall at the final hurdle? No! I got through and the crowd went crazy! Now the aim was for George to film from the side, however this security guard asked to see his ticket and obviously it said he wasn't meant to be there, so he sent him back to the stands.
Okay, so it looks like obviously the fake ticket that George was used in this instance did get found out by one of the security guards. Unfortunately, that same security guard did just let someone who had a fake pass straight through. It just goes to show that having kind of a system in place, some kind of security infrastructure, where instead of just letting people through, obviously there's a lot of people, they have to deal with them as much as possible, but when coming into like ringside contact, you have to make sure the people who are coming in are meant to be there, otherwise that's a serious security hazard. Obviously in this case, Niko isn't really, you know, posing any kind of threat to anyone, but if this happened to be someone else, realistically this wasn't a very difficult thing to do. All they had to do was make fake passes, the fake wristbands, and then buy a normal ticket, and they were in ringside just because they looked confident enough. This would definitely be something of a pain point, something that would definitely have to be kind of reviewed as footage and checked to make sure, okay, where did the issues start? First off, just letting him down there in the first place, letting George down there, and second off, obviously letting him, you know, ringside.
But on my first attempt, I was denied access, so I tried again from the other side. Maybe if I looked like I was meant to be there, they wouldn't question it.
So here's an important part. Obviously, he was denied access the first time. It was kind of just shooed off or whatever like that. It should have been at this point that the guards kind of spoke to each other and said, hey, look, there's somebody who just tried to get into the ring. Make sure we keep an eye on him. This wasn't kept. You can see sort of just in this clip here that one of the guards isn't even looking at Niko at this point. So obviously it allows him to kind of sneak past him and stuff like that. But this is definitely where communication is key. Having some kind of system set up where they can just talk to each other. Obviously, it's quite loud in the venue, so they'd have to, you know, shout across to each other. But, you know, keeping an eye on suspicious characters is definitely something that is, you know, it's not really optional when it comes to the job.
Whoa,
whoa, whoa, whoa. Chill, get out.
Get ready to see some black belt waffling.
Get out.
Let go. How am I meant to get out like this?
Let go.
They all swarm me, man. I had been caught.
Get out.
So you can see here, as soon as he enters the ring, you know, he gets caught by one of the guards and apprehended. In the case of using force, you should only ever really use force as a guard when it's absolutely necessary. In this case, it very much was. While obviously he wasn't posing any kind of physical or anything, any threat like that, there's a very high chance that just any kind of random person who, you know, has the balls to kind of do this is going to potentially, you know, pose a threat to someone, is going to maybe, you know, hide a concealed weapon, something like that. There definitely should have been kind of procedures in place to stop him from getting there in the first place, but good on the guards for sort of, you know, surrounding him, making sure that basically he wasn't able to get any further than he already did.
Despite my efforts to leave as fast as possible, they decided to take me off the premises themselves.
Yeah, so here they're obviously giving him a security escort off the premises. Pretty standard stuff. You definitely don't want to let someone, especially someone who's just gotten into the ring, you don't want to let them just walk out on their own. You don't know what else kind of stuff they're going to do, whether they're going to, you know, threaten other people or they're going to take things or anything like that. You want to make sure basically they get off your property and stuff like that. Because at the end of the day, the security of this venue is in the security company's hands. And so they want to make sure that any, you know, potential people like Niko or something like that who could cause any kind of damage, you know, people who are obviously willing to bend the rules, they want to make sure they're off the property on their watch, you know what I mean? Because any incidents or stuff like that, it'll have to be reported. This will definitely be written up in an incidents report, taken back to the security supervisors, stuff like that. So if these same security company are used for future boxing events, it will be noted down, Niko as a person, basically, to just keep an eye on stuff like that. So yeah, that's pretty much the video. It just seems to be a case of obviously making the fake passes, the fake wristbands, going in and kind of acting confidently enough to get past the guards. It's something that a lot of people have kind of been seen to do, especially on places like construction sites. It's kind of a situation of if you're confident enough in the way you present yourself, you know, a lot of people think they can kind of go wherever they want. Now, when it comes to having like a trained security company on guard, there should definitely be a lot more procedures in place. As I say, he just flashed a fake pass and he was managed to get ringside. That's something that there should definitely be manually checked, or having kind of a scanner system, you know, maybe some kind of electronic gate or something, especially for such a high profile boxing match. It's something that there should have been a little bit more tighter security on there. As I say, he was able to get into the ring itself, which should never have even happened. He shouldn't have even gotten into ringside itself. So yeah, there were definitely a lot of flaws. I just want to clarify, this wasn't our security company who did the security for this place. We don't actually know who did the security for this. But that would definitely be kind of our recommendations and suggestions in terms of looking at the video from a security perspective.